Oh yeah?
Like 5 dollars, $10.
Crazy for 1 million followers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
902K.
What?
How much is this like worth in watches?
Say 1 million.
$1 million worth. Yeah.
Yo!
Good and you?
Good, good.
What's
good.
The plan today, bro?
Today is gonna be special. Now, what time is it though? 2:12. So we're gonna go and see 3 of my friends who are also multimillionaire like me. And I'm gonna ask them what they do. So how they make their fortune, how much they make per month, their biggest day, their biggest loss, just for you to get to know them. But we have one issue. I don't know what car we're gonna take because I said to my driver, day off, because I wanna drive today, enjoy. Either we take Toyota or the McLaren. So which car are we taking?
McLaren could be sick, bro.
Yeah. Actually. Where are the keys? Let me just see where the keys are. I don't know where the keys are. Okay, so we're gonna go with the Urus. Maybe the keys are in the car, so let's go. Yeah, we're gonna take the key of the Urus with us and probably take care of the McLaren, or I lost the key. Let's go.
So, are the keys inside?
Let's see.
Oh, yeah?
What do you say?
I don't know if the keys are inside and it keeps.
You have to run. This guy is stealing. Stealing the car.
Maybe the keys of the McLaren are in the Urus. I don't know where the keys are. We're kinda stuck. This is a tricky situation. Anyway, let's not waste time. Let's go to my friends. They take the Urus. Anyway, still a good car to drive, so let's go. So we're on the way. We're first gonna go see my friend Nathan. Nathan is doing a lot of stuff in life and he's younger than me. So I'm young, I'm 25, but I think he's 22, 23, something like this. And he made a lot of money, like a lot, guys. So we're on the way to his, and he has like one of the sickest house I have ever been in Dubai. And last year for New Year, he did a massive, massive, massive party. You know what, Ilyas, ask him like if he's gonna do a new party. Yeah, the same thing. Thank you for having me. So guys, this is my friend Nathan. We are in his small, very, very small house, as you can see.
Yeah, very small.
So we're gonna go inside, have a house tour, have a chat about it. Nathan, why do you have a boat?
Well, I start a wakeboard company now in Dubai.
Yeah.
So I put first boat to start. I'm waiting for next approval for government to start the business. Then I will buy like 4 or 5 boats and put them all in the water and launch this new business. I hope it will go good.
And how much is a boat like this?
It's like 180,000 dirhams, so around $50,000. It's cheap one for start, and then we'll buy only new boat around $150,000. But this one is just to get
to start the business.
Learn and to see how it goes, to form also the team and everything.
And how much do you rent for an hour? For
it's
a
like
day?
600 dirham a day, an hour with a wakeboard instructor. So it's like $200 an hour, yeah.
Oh, so you can, it's a good business model, yeah?
You can do $1,500 a day, something like this.
Wow, that's crazy. So, since how long have you been living in that house?
It's the second year, no?
Second year? Still enjoying?
Yeah, it's good.
It's big.
Only the neighbor are killing their mind with a walk outside, but that's okay.
One of the sickest houses I think I have been in Dubai.
Yeah, it's mostly, I think one of the biggest.
But why so big? Because you probably don't use all the space anyway.
It's fine. It's not,
just for you?
It's not very expensive, it's okay.
That's the main point. So Nathan, before talking about what are all the businesses and every like hot topic, how old are you? Because people are gonna be shocked.
I'm 22.
When did you start business?
I started when I was 12. The most
10
important.
Years.
Yeah, it's been 10 years now.
Okay, can you tell us a story? How did you start? Like, what were you doing at 12? Because most people like,
What they do, they play football at that age, play yeah. video games, so...
Yeah, I was not good at football, so yeah. I have to do something else. No, I was doing windsurf. It's a very expensive sport, you know. It's not football, you buy shoes and then you go to a football match. And my mom, she's a teacher in France, so she's not making too much money. It was hard for my family to support me for the windsurf and everything. So I had to work on my side to find sponsor and everything. So I just started some business on social media.
So you were already open to find new way to make money?
Yeah, I found the first way was just to grow Facebook page online. I create some Facebook page with some thematic, like funny thematic, etc. And I bring them to like 1 million, 2 million followers, and then I start to sell ads on the
and
page.
At what age, 12?
Yes, at 12.
At 12 years old, you were making pages going to 1 million.
Yeah, it was very easy, honestly. At this period, it was easy. It was just needed to post a lot. I was just taking what was working good in the USA, translate in French, and then post in my page.
Wow.
And that was working.
That's crazy.
So I was starting to make $500, $1,000 a month. And
selling promos on
yeah,
the page?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was selling it like $5, $10.
Oh, crazy. For 1 million followers.
Yeah,
page.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
It was not like today.
Offered. That was offered for them.
Yeah, it was different than today. Of course, today you will make maybe $100,000 with this kind of page.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
I started a new thing after, and that's fine.
Okay, and then, so you start first with pages, and then how did you
yeah,
like?
Then I moved to many different kind of business. First one was still related to influencer marketing. Instead of a Facebook page, I directly contacted all the influencers in France and in Europe, and I just reached them out like, yo, I have 10 million on Facebook. I can get your content more viral, etc. But if I do an ad for you, you will need to do an ad for me.
Okay.
So I start like this, and when I got maybe 10, 15 influencers to agree with me, I start to sell them to some brands. So basically all the brands were contacting me for ads on my page. I was also offering other kind of influencer. And
okay.
me, it was not costing me any money. I was not paying the influencer. I was just giving a shout out to the influencer.
Okay, so the influencer were promoting something for you and you were just promoting the influencer on your page.
Yes, exactly. So I start like this. So it was better because influencer, you can sell them for $500, $600 instead of $10, you know?
Yeah.
So it was the good way to make more money for me at the beginning. Then I start to do like reselling of all the like online shoes, like Yeezy, Supreme, etc., all these clothes.
Okay.
I make maybe 15,000 a month with this.
Whoa, that's a lot. Our age?
Yes, I was having like 14, something like this.
At 14?
Yeah.
So you were rich for your age, no?
Yeah, I was good.
Oh my God, 14 and you have like $15,000 per month. That's crazy.
Yeah, it was good. It was very easy, honestly, to do this business. I just paid the guy.
I don't think it's easy. I think you just had like the right mindset
yeah.
and the motivation of a hustler, because most people think, oh, it's easy.
Yeah, yeah.
I go find a supplier. It's not that easy, or everyone would do it, you know? So you need to spend time and be good with your relationship. I think you are good with relationship
yes,
with people.
Yes, yes. That's the most important thing in the business anyway, I think. Whatever you do, if you have good relation, it will work.
Okay, and then after selling the shoes?
After I pushed more of influence marketing again, but not with a Facebook page. I start directly to manage the influencer directly. So
okay.
I came to them like, okay, you work with me in the past and you know how it was good. It bringed you a good volume of new people, etc. I know how to make you grow on social media, and I also know how to giving you good deals, good
brands,
etc. So I've started to manage influencer. It was Musical.ly at the period, not TikTok.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So they,
I
started
wow.
with, yeah, a long time ago, like 9 years ago. 8-9 years. I was managing all the French biggest influencers on Musical.ly, and I was making good money. So
okay. also brand deals.
Yes, everything. We did everything with them. Like I was having office in Paris as well for this.
Being young.
Yeah, I was 14, so I was.
Some people do that at like 40 years old. He was a guy like 16 years old. That's just nuts.
I was with a guy who was having a big office, so I was renting from him a part of office to work and bring my talent at the office and everything. Because when you're 14 and you manage influencers, the influencers which were also young, like 15, 16, etc., their parents are behind it, like, who are you working with? Can I meet him, etc.? If you take the train
for
and
coffee,
go,
they
will feel like strange, you know, the guy is 14 years old, but if they come to your office directly, it's not the same story.
Yeah, you put like, this is what I was even telling you, like, you know, when I have a business meeting and I send a Rolls Royce to someone, like it always like bring like a whole structure, like an ecosystem towards the meeting. So it's exactly what Nathan is saying. Like if he would go in a coffee and meet up to talk about like a big deal, like 5,000, 10,000, it's around a coffee. coffee, nobody's gonna take it seriously. But if they come to his office, then like it's totally different.
Yeah, 100%.
And then Musical.ly died, so how did you...
I moved to TikTok, Snapchat and Instagram.
Okay.
And both worked good.
That was your biggest business?
Yeah, but still the business I'm doing today.
But where was it more working, now, before?
No, before it was way better, honestly. Okay. Before it was way better, and also I was more motivated by the business. But at the end, you know, when influence marketing started to die slowly in France and in Europe, I was like, my client's not making money, you know, it's not funny. When the client paying an ad 5,000 and then make $2,000 of sale only, is losing like 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. So at the end, it's not good for me and my reputation. So I slowly start to reduce this business and focus on new other kind of business.
So let's talk about like the hot topic about how much you make and everything, if you're a fan, of course.
Because yeah, I know it's okay.
I don't know if
we're in Dubai. I'm not gonna.
I'm not gonna
go to London tomorrow. It's okay. I will keep safe.
Can you show us the house? Because obviously, I think like everyone wanna see your house behind the camera. So if you can.
Sure. It's fine. Let's do a room tour.
How many bedrooms do you have in the?
We have 7 bedrooms.
7 bedrooms.
Yes. Plus 1 driver room and 1 maid room.
Wow, and that's 9 bedrooms. And how many living rooms do you have? Because that's 2, though.
I have 2, yeah. This is small one, and the other one, which is the biggest one where we were.
This is when you get in fight with your friends, someone goes to watch TV there.
Yeah, if you fight with someone, then you can go other side of the house.
Yes,
if I'm fighting with my girlfriend, she can stay there.
I like the pool. Like, was the house fully furnished and pool?
No. Even the pool, we make it.
Whoa, crazy.
So we are someone to make the pool, and so we can do our own design, you know, it's better. Because if the landlord make the pool for you, it will make a 6-meter pool, you know?
Yeah, true. Do you have an office here?
Yeah, upstairs.
Okay, let's go see your office. Wow, so wait, you have four offices?
Yeah, we have some office space.
So who's the office?
It's Romain, my business partner.
And there, who's there?
Me, I stay mostly there.
Okay.
Most of the time. I don't like to have a big TV.
Yeah, me neither. I'm not a big screen guy.
I'm not on computer too much anyway, so it's fine. And all this part is good. Because we can play all.
Do you play that often or not really?
Not really.
No, at the beginning, and then after you stop.
You just buy, so it's good. That's it.
No, it's sick, bro. Like, wow. And so that's your other business partner?
No, it's just my girlfriend sometimes when she's working. She's from there. And it's Alex. Other business partner is working for me.
Golden CBD.
Yeah, Golden CBD brand.
Shout out, send me 10,000 for the promo. So, you also have like an outside.
We have outside area, everything. Then.
You have another floor?
Yeah, we have rooftop. Of course.
Do you use the rooftop or never?
For the party mostly, yeah.
Ah, okay.
Party, barbecue, extra.
Whoa! You use the jacuzzi, yeah?
Of course.
Wow.
We can be in jacuzzi and then. Seeing the Burj Khalifa view, but also the working view, which was not the year when we started to rent the house.
Yeah,
but
you know, like you're close to my house. You're like 15 minutes by car.
Yeah, it's very near from everything.
Yeah, it's near. So Ines was saying, because I wasn't there last year, I was in New York with my with a friend. You had like a big party. Are you gonna do a party this year?
Yeah, we're gonna do the same.
Okay.
Maybe better.
Better,
yeah. Okay. We'll do more bigger party, more number of person, more quality of people as well, more alcohol.
Let's go. That's gonna be sick. So everyone who's watching the YouTube video, you can come. So now that Nathan is holding his kleps, aka dog in English. Nathan, so as you said, you made the biggest amount of money with this influencer agency. How much were you making, like your biggest month or per year? Like what's the type of?
I think my biggest month was $700,000.
Profit?
Yes.
Whoa.
And biggest month in terms of revenue, not profit, was maybe $15 million.
In 1 month?
Yeah, 1 month.
Wow, that's crazy.
During NFTs mostly. We were handling all of the marketing for all the projects. So we are.
So people were coming to you, I want that influencer, yeah. that page.
Exactly.
Here is 200K, what can you do?
Exactly.
And would they come and ask you for an influencer, or would they come and tell you, I have a budget, I trust you and whatever?
They come into me, like, mostly, I have a budget, I have like 200, 300, 400,000, manage the budget and make the best for me. And then I just send proposition to them of a list of influencer, page, etc. And if they approve, they pay and we start the campaign. So mostly it's like this, and on our side, we are taking a cut from the influencer price.
Okay. Exactly. Now that we're saying that, because you were making that money at like 20 years old?
Yeah, I was 20. Yeah.
20. So how did your brain react? Like, did you go crazy or?
I always did a lot of money. So, you know, when I was 16.
That's a lot of money, you know, like when you're 20 and you make 700K a month.
Yeah, but when you're 16 and you make 150,000, it's more impressive.
Yeah, that's actually true.
So on my side, between my 15 to 18, I was already making like 100,000 a month. It didn't shock me. Just like maybe during 6 months, I was maybe just too relaxed and I stopped to work and I was just spending maybe 200,000 in club in a month. I bought also two nightclubs in France.
Okay, so you own clubs?
Yeah, two.
Okay, sick. And so now you said like the market, like marketing agency
yeah,
went
marketing
down.
Yeah, marketing shit, no.
So what are you doing right now?
Yeah, so I have a rental car as well. So I invest a lot of money in car rental. I have 16 cars in Dubai, which I rent. And as you can see today, all car out, so business is going good, yeah. Only the Rolls Royce stay here.
What's the name of your brand?
It's Divine Car Rental.
Divine Car Rental,
yeah.
Amazing. So who is renting to you? Like, I know, but for them who is watching, like...
Most of the entrepreneur, most of the influencer, most
artists.
Of the guy who come to Dubai and visit, yeah, most of the artists as well, like Swally, etc. They went from me, Peggy Goo, etc. So, yeah.
So all the celebrities go to...
Yeah, all the celebrities went from me.
Because it's all relationship. And so you've been like kind of successful because you did like 5-6 different like ventures, and this is impressive. What would be like the advice you would give to someone who's watching right now? And no matter the age, he can be 20 or 40 and maybe he thinks it's too late or he's too young. You are the proof that you're never too young to do business. So what would be the advice you would give to someone who's watching this?
I would say just stay straight all the way. Whenever you have opportunity to make something like not good, don't do it, you know? Because at the end, when your business is done, what counts is your relation. If
network.
You stole from some the network, if you stole from someone 100,000 because at your age of 15 you thought it was a good idea because it was 100,000 and you was thinking your business can make you only 1,000. It's not the good way to do business. At the end, being straight with everyone.
Always straight and keep your relation.
Yes, keep your relation will make you doing new business every time and will make you way more money than everything else. As you see me, when marketing went down, I start rental car. It's making good money. Then on the side of rental car, because I also need to make more money, you know,
yeah.
To buy more car, I start a concierge service for flights. So we have deal with Emirates, with Etihad, with most of the airlines.
What's the name of your page?
It's concierge. Just add concierge.
So people just go on Instagram, put concierge, and
yes.
It's your page.
Yeah, it's
you have
page.
The add concierge.
Yes, add concierge.
Whoa,
yeah.
Nuts. Crazy. Okay, so if you wanna fly,
yeah.
You know where to go, guys.
We have this with a good discount up to 70% in business and first class. So all the clients who come to me in Dubai with concierge, they also and car for me, they also
you,
ask
you create
me
a whole
everything.
Ecosystem
yeah,
about
360, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's good.
I think that's very inspiring as a story. Thank you, Nathan.
Thank you, bro. Not better than your story, but still, I'm working on it.
See you for New Year, yeah.
Before.
Or maybe before for some parties. So now we're going to the second friend, the second multimillionaire one, Big Jack, who's in the same industry as me, investor. So he's investing, yeah.
Just arrived Jack's place. Big Jack, he's a very serious persona and a bit funny when you know him properly.
So we just arrived at Jack's place, so let's go.
Hello!
Bro! It's your man.
How are you, Jack?
Bro.
Good, yeah? I didn't know you were playing FIFA!
Huh?
Do you have a good team?
Bro, what do you mean do I have a good team? Look at this.
Kylian Mbappé.
If anyone in the video knows FIFA, look at this. Mbappe, Ousmane Dembele, 90 Odegaard, Rooney, Kante. Bro, how much did I spend on this team? Too much.
So how much did you spend on FIFA?
This year, EA 24?
Yeah.
Like, $6,000? Yeah, it's not good.
You have a very peaceful life then.
This is how you make money, bro. It's peace of mind.
Peace of mind.
Hard work. And relax, you know? No bullshit here, no bullshit.
This guy is crazy.
Guys, my apartment is very, very dirty, so I'm gonna bring Joe downstairs to the lobby. Yes, Joe?
Yeah. Let's go.
So, first thing first, thank you, Jack, for having us.
No problem.
And for sharing your story with the front of the camera. So, first thing I always ask, how old are you?
I'm 24 years old from Dublin, Ireland.
So, Jack, can you tell us what do you do for a living?
First of all, I'm a trader, investor, I have some e-commerce businesses.
So, you have three main activities. First thing, can you show them how much you're up this week, Big Jack?
I'll show the month.
Okay, yeah, show them.
The month is nicer because this week has been slow.
Okay.
You can see the full trade history here. Hey. So, he's gonna want to take some more profits. 102k.
What? It's a demo.
No, real account. for my company. Most of the profit this month was on gold, which is something that like I also invest in, like physical gold.
So wait, you made 900k this month. What was your biggest month?
This is close to like my biggest month. Biggest month ever was like 1.5 million.
It's almost double, bro.
Yeah, but this month's not over. We're only.
Oh yeah, it's actually true, bro.
Yeah.
I just realized. Yeah, we're
only the month isn't over.
So you might beat your best month. Inshallah.
Touch wood, bro. Touch wood.
Okay, and how did you start this whole like trading stuff?
My actual real story is when I was 14 years old, I had a Facebook account. When Facebook was like the biggest social media platform, it was like no Instagram, no TikTok, everything was on Facebook. So I had meme accounts and football meme accounts. So, you know, like basically what was happening in football, they would be like turned into memes or like news and stuff. I built the Facebook page to like, and this will make sense why I'm telling this story now, to like 300-400k likes.
Same story as Nathan, crazy.
Yeah, yeah. So I built the page to like 300-400k likes. I had some smaller meme pages on like 100-200k, and I was like 14 years old, and I was managing like 10 admins at the time. So I'm like 14 years old, and like technically I'm already running a business. You have to manage the admins, the timing of the posts, the quality of the posts. Like I was a 14 year old kid behind the computer, and I was like telling people who are like in their 20s in uni and stuff, like no, don't post at this time, post at this time, remove this quality is crap, no, this is not a good idea, don't post this. So I already took on that responsibility of like managing not just money, like but people, emotions, a business, you know, because I was getting paid for ads on these pages. A lot of sports betting companies like Bet365, Paddy Power, I don't know if, like what the more, like Ladbrokes, all the online gambling companies were paying me for ads. Then there was like ProDirect is a big one for, you know, sports shoes, like football boots. So they were paying me for ads, football jersey, like websites, like you can get the, you know, like new Real Madrid kit with printed on the back, and we'd have discount code. So I'd earn commission from the discount code. I'd also get a fee for the post, and I was 14 at the time, so like all the money was going to my mum's PayPal.
How much you were making a month?
At this point I was making like $6,000-$7,000 at like at 14 years old, and I'm going to school, and like the teacher, I'm probably earning more than the teacher, correct?
Yeah, for sure, like, bro.
And plus that, I'm 14, I've got no expenses, zero expense. Like when you think about it, like all that money
just
was going
your
back.
Staff. Just your staff.
And here's the thing, a lot of my staff were working for free because they also, the way it worked was they also had their own meme pages, and I would allow them to credit their
meme
accounts. So they are getting followers organically from my thing, and this was the way we worked, you know?
Okay, so a win-win deal basically.
Yeah, win-win deal. They're getting traffic to build their own thing. I mean, I'm getting the best content and the content on my profile first, you know? That's the beginning of like my entrepreneurial story. So all the money was going to my mom's PayPal. You know, I had to like go and ask my mom, like, hey, these new Nike shoes are nice. Can you order them with my money? And she'd be like, no, why are you spending this money? You need to save. Anyway, it came to the point where I lost the passion for like meme pages and this and this. So I sold the biggest one I had to like an online betting company. So I got like a lump sum. And then at this point, when I got the lump sum plus the money I had saved, I'm like 15, 16. So I quit school. Like I didn't finish.
At 15, 16, you quit school?
Yeah, I didn't do like, wow. I didn't do like the.
You didn't study?
Yeah, I didn't do any, no uni, no.
High school?
No, nothing. High school. Yeah, I left high school. So at this point, you know, you're going into, think about it, you're going to school every day, and there's teachers telling you what, like the teacher's not even allowing me to go to the bathroom. They're like, I'm raised man, can I go to the bathroom, please? No. And I'm sitting there with like 100K, 150K in my bank, and I'm going like, what the fuck is this, you know?
Yeah.
You know, like maybe now when you look back, it might have been good to get the education to have it, you know, but when you're that young and you've made that amount of money and you've managed people and like 24/7 you're managing people and stuff already, you kind of think you're above.
Yeah, it's normal, you know, like, it's normal.
So I was always like pushing away my parents. They kind of understood, they let me leave school. Then when I...
So they supported you like mentally?
Yes. In the beginning, my mom, no, but you know, when I sat down, explained everything, they kind of saw my vision, you know, and they trusted me then to do my own thing. So then from leaving school at 16, I had this money behind me, so I was like, okay, now I need to add to this money. I can't just sit here. And Facebook was going a bit dead. Instagram was starting to pop up. Twitter was starting to pop up. So like the money was going away from Facebook Facebook pages, and I knew like there's a cap on how much you can make with a Facebook page, you know, like what's the maximum you can make from a Facebook page. Okay, maybe I can do 10k a month, but it's never gonna bring me to like the
500k,
so I was like, okay. So like I used to like play around on like YouTube, I used to like try so many different things. Then I first I got into trading, some e-commerce. So from 16 I've been trading basically. From when I finished school I've been trading. Same story as most people. The first 2 years I lost a lot of money. I originally started to like, I took some courses, I was watching, some of these guys are still around actually. Some good YouTubers on trading, technical analysis, risk management, how to trade. And then like 18, 19 is when I kind of started to break the profitability barrier, you know. Things started to come a bit more natural, less emotion and things like this. Then from there at like 19 I started to make some really good money. Also had some e-commerce stores, you know, on the side, because as well, you know yourself, trading, you can only spend like 1-2 hours a day on the charts realistically.
Rest
is like managing your emotions, waiting for the trades to come to you, holding the trades, managing the trade, you know. You do some other business on the side. So from these two together, then I was earning some really good money. And then obviously the tax in Europe is ridiculous. So I moved everything here to UAE, to Dubai.
And when did you start making, because obviously you start making 900K in like literally 9 days, so that's 100K a day at the moment. My question is, when was like the first month you made 100K from trading? How did you feel?
I made 100K, it was during COVID, I think. I remember I had some really good months in COVID, between crypto, because the crypto bull run was ridiculous, and then trading. And then gold as well, I was trading gold a lot, and like Donald Trump would just speak, and if you're on the right side of gold, like hitting TP, 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 you know?
Yeah.
Everything happened really fast, but I remember like, I've always kind of made money and had money, so it's just like numbers on a screen, but like it feels overwhelming when you, and then you start to withdraw that money, and then it doesn't really hit you until you look back and you're saying, oh, now I can buy this, I can buy this, I can do this, I can travel here, I can buy this watch, I can buy this car.
So,
you know, it's like...
What was your dream car?
I have my dream car now.
What's your car?
Mansory Urus.
Can you go and see it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. How long ago did you buy the car?
I think, yeah, 4 or 5 months now I have the car.
It's hot.
But even still now, you know, I look at my neighbor's cars. This is the good thing as well about living in Dubai, because...
Look at that car.
Yeah,
Rolls.
It's like a vintage Rolls Royce. Like, the thing is as well, when you live in Dubai, even though I have this car, everyone around me is still like...
Having sick cars.
Yeah, you know, like I don't feel like it's a thing anymore. Like there's a... Next to me, there's like a 1 of 50 Mansory Rolls Royce. 1 of 50. You know, like every day you look and there is new cars, new everything, new.
Oof.
But still, yeah, this is...
Jack's car is here. Amazing.
Yeah, bro.
What a beauty. What a beauty. So, how did you feel when you bought that car, bro?
I always wanted the car. I knew I would get one, to be honest. Like, I've had the money for this car for a long time, but you know, I really, really wanted to be clear of a certain amount of money to, you know, buy this type of car, you know, because it's not cheap. So when I bought it, it was like a relief.
Yeah?
Yeah, because I knew for like 2-3 years I would buy this car eventually. Well, the day I got it, you know, it was like a booking list check, you know?
Yeah. This is a sick car, like when story like this.
It's a lot of attention, especially even in Dubai. Like it's hard, you know, in Dubai, because there's so many cars, but even still it gets a...
Yeah, you recognize like a Mansory like this. How much you bought that car?
It was like 450K.
USD?
Yeah.
$500,000 for a car. Jack.
Yes.
So now people know you make money, they know you have a good car. What would be like the advice you would give that someone wanna start?
Big risks, because to be honest, so many people as well, I'm sure, as they come to you, they come to me and they say, bro, I wanna make money, I wanna do this. But then when it comes to like investing money, they're like, nah, blah, blah, but they'll go out and they'll buy the new iPhone, they'll buy the new shoes, they will go to the restaurant every weekend. Like I've seen you say it on your stories, because even with everything, as I said before, my Facebook accounts, my every business I've had to spend money to make the money back. Every business, you look how much expense they have. Every business has an expense. Trading, investing, physical business, an online business. You know, you have to get your stock, staff, everything. People are scared of investing money or spending money to make money.
Yeah,
this is the number one thing. And then obviously education, like educate yourself. Me, I spent I don't know how many hours on YouTube watching what other people are doing. I'm like, if this guy is doing it correctly, then I can do it too, you know? Look at somebody who's doing what you want to do. Like,
and who has the results.
Yeah, and has the results, you know? Check what they're doing and then do it yourself, you know? There's no like secret or magic thing, you know? You don't have to reinvent anything. You don't need a magic thing. You don't need to crack a code. It's just education and investing, hard work. That's
And for people who knew, because we're in the same game. For people who say trading is a scam, why would you answer to them?
Small-minded.
Yeah.
Small-minded because, like, how many people do we know that make money from trading, from even just spot trading crypto? I know people who spot trade without leverage crypto. Obviously, you have to have a lot of money to make profit from that, but I know people who just spot buy crypto on the day, and when it moves up, they sell, or if they're, you know, like, there's people only buying crypto, and then they sell it, like, but they're buying with millions, obviously, to make. Trading has this reputation because of the amount of scams that there is. For example, fake accounts. There's fake accounts of you. There's even fake accounts of me. They will not give you the right education. They will not give you the right tools to actually make money. And then they will lose some money, and they will say, oh, it's a scam, it's a scam. They will never try it again. Me, it took me 2 years to actually make profits, to get the right education, to get the right risk management.
Try and just see how it goes.
Yeah, but you have to try with the right tools, the right
person, thing.
The right mentor. The right thing. Number one, don't send money to fake accounts, and number two, don't follow like a
random guy,
yeah, or like a 16-year-old kid in America who doesn't have anything, and he's like, yeah, I'm gonna show you how to trade, and he'll tell you to like full margin your account on a gold trade on the first day. You'll lose all your money, and then of course you're gonna think it's a scam.
Yeah,
because you listen to a 16-year-old kid or a guy who just came from Jordy Shore, like he was there like 2 weeks ago partying and whatever, and now he's a professional trader, you know? Like,
yeah, ridiculous.
Like, come on, you know? That's the only message really I have to people who say trading is a scam, but like,
I think Jack, you said it all, bro.
Bro, there's nothing else to say, bro.
Facts,
really.
Facts. Like, Jack, thank you very much for your time,
bro. And, it's always a pleasure, bro.
Hopefully God will give you more, your brain will give you more, and I see you like probably tomorrow. Let's go, because we're Thursday, so tomorrow we have to go party anyway.
Bro, Friday, come on, bro. Come on. This guy wants to party too much. This guy wants to party too much. I'm trying to grind. I'm trying to be on his level. I'm trying to be on a level like him.
Yeah, no, but guys, thank you. Thank you very much, Jack, for coming. And now we're going to see my third friend who's a millionaire. He's in the other industry. We're going to see Suleiman, you know?
Ah, because I love Suleiman. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Suleiman's
he's
a good
crazy guy. He's a crazy guy. So, guys, see you soon. So guys, this is my friend Suleiman, so thank you for having us.
Nice, nice to meet you.
He's probably one of the craziest ones. Here it's a bit noisy, there is a very lovely woman playing piano, so can we jump at yours?
Yeah, let's go at my place right now. And...
okay, let's go. So obviously when you see that guy like this, you probably think he's a hacker or a coder or something.
Why everyone say that?
Because you look like a nerd though.
Everyone say that. Like a nerd.
What did you hack to become rich?
No, I hacked nothing. So basically I started with e-commerce.
Really?
Yeah, dropshipping.
Okay, can you explain like what's e-commerce for maybe some people don't know what it is?
It means that I didn't have stock, but I just built my store. I do advertisement with the products. And once I have sales, it's sending directly the orders to the supplier in China, which is sending the products to the customer directly.
You had a lot of shops before?
Yeah, so I started in 2018.
Okay, like, so that was like five years ago.
5 years ago. I was 19. I started with products for cats and dogs. So I did my ads myself. So I took videos.
So you did everything for yourself?
Yeah, I was looking every day on YouTube, like tutorials, how to do that, step by step, how to build a Shopify store and stuff. I didn't buy a course at the beginning. And that's how I made some money.
Which was the one that made you the biggest amount of money?
The first shop that I had, so it was selling stuff for animals. It was the best store for me at the beginning. So it was my first real store.
And how much you made with that store?
I made maybe like 400K in like 1 year and a half. So okay. For me, it was very good, you know, because I was like from zero. I started with zero.
From the scratch, you're making 400K.
Yeah. And then I had another store, but the main store that I got and made me a lot of money. It was a brand, so I had a stock. This time I paid for the stock in advance.
So it's a bit different. It was more from drop shipping into e-com.
Yeah, it was like more a brand, you know. Yeah. Even if it was cheap, I was selling watches for 10 euro.
No, the shop was for watches?
Yeah.
You're a watch lover. And, but we're going to review. You have the watches here, yeah?
Yeah, I'll show you some.
Okay, we will show you after.
But yeah, so I just had my brand. I just bought some watches and I just put my logo on it. I did like a packaging. So I had to buy some stock directly from the supplier, but the stock was still in China. I didn't have stock in Europe, but my market was Europe. And I did like 3.5 million with this.
3.5 million in 2 years. Wow. Yeah. And that was like the big first step for you to become like a millionaire.
Yeah, it was like, okay, so that's real, you know.
Okay, and how did you, because you were young, you were like 20 years old, you started seeing like millions coming. Like, how did your brain react? Did you go crazy?
So, no, not at all. So, at the beginning, I was living in France. So, when I was living in France, I still had my company in France. So, I had to pay some taxes. So, I didn't spend a lot of money. I spent nothing, to be honest. Only some stuff. I just bought my first watch at 21.
But what was your watch?
Like a Rolex Datejust. I'll show you later. Watch. But when I came to Dubai, like, I started to spend a little bit more, you know?
You want a woman?
No. Not at all. Like, at the beginning, it was like car rentals and... I bought my first luxury t-shirt, like Balenciaga. But I was still keeping a lot, you know?
Yeah. I'm not You're still a big conservative.
Spender. Yeah, I'm not a spender. I'm not a big spender. And then I did more money.
And you don't drink, so...
Yeah, I don't drink. I don't spend in nightclubs. So yeah, it's fine. I still had money. I spent more when I moved to Dubai. After that, when I made a lot of money in my business, I spent too much. So, and then I realized that I did something bad.
So for you, like the main thing was like doing drop shipping. Then you turned to drop shipping into e-com. And then after that, what exactly did you do?
So I started with dropshipping. Then I had my brand, but it was still dropshipping because I didn't have the stock in my, like, I didn't have a warehouse or stuff. And then I did like a lot of investment in crypto. So cryptocurrencies, like in the during the bull run 2021.
I feel like everyone in Dubai made so much money.
Yeah,
during,
so
like,
that's when I did a lot of money, you know, like a lot of money. And then I started to stop working. Like I didn't want to start e-commerce again because it's really like you have to work a lot of, you know, a lot of hours. You have to spend a lot of time behind your screen to like target the right audience, to cut the ads, to you know, it's
really management.
Yeah, it's not like money, you make nothing, you know. You have to work in e-commerce. But then when I did a lot of money with crypto, I didn't want to work anymore, you know. It was weird because when you make a lot of money, suddenly you don't want to work. Like,
it's I think like your mind is like changing. You just swift and you go from like being, because even me before, I was such a hustler, and then you make so much money that at some point you're just like, oh, you just want to like sit and make easy money. Money, you don't necessarily, like, you want to make big money, but only if it doesn't take you too much effort. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. You don't have the hunger anymore. Like,
yeah, before you're like a dog, man.
Bro, I had like, I was dreaming about, you know, e-commerce. I was waking up on my screen, like on my desktop, on my laptop, working, and going to sleep again. You know, I was like really hustling. And now I cannot do that anymore, you know, I don't open my computer.
It's crazy.
Anymore.
So what do you do? Like, how do you make money
now? So now I like to invest my money because I did a lot of cash. So I like to invest like in watches, art, real estate. I like to invest with you, you know, in stock market and forex trading. So that's what I do now. Like I don't work a lot, but I like what I do.
Yeah, yeah. Because you have like a huge capital. Now you can just diversify and make X amount here, X amount. And because, yeah, you said you're investing in watch. Can you maybe bring your watches so people can...
Yeah, so I have my watch here. Like,
I think it's one of your favorite watch.
Yeah, take it. Come back.
Yeah, bring the other one. Yeah. This watch, guys, is so crazy. So this is like a frosted AP chronograph. During the bull run, this watch went for over 200K. Suleiman, this watch was going for 200K, right?
Yeah, I bought it 200K.
Yeah, he bought it for 200K. Imagine, man spent 200 bucks on a normal watch, then you have my brokey watch, now I'm joking, which is like 150. But no, this is one literally my favorite watch ever. Because you know what I like with AP is that it's not diamonds right here. It's like they have something that just breaks the steel and that it makes look like this.
It's not steel, bro, it's white gold.
Oh, sorry. So it breaks the white gold.
Yeah, it's like...
But it's not diamonds.
It's not
that
diamonds.
Breaks. And it's made that shining. Yeah, it's frosted.
It's like an Italian technique.
Yeah. So.
So I have some watches here. I have plenty more in the safe, but I just brought some. So that's my first watch. That's my first watch.
Will you ever sell that one?
No, I'll never sell it. I want to give it to my kids if I have some.
So that's how do you live if you have few?
That's a Rolex Datejust. I'll give it to my first son. Rolex Datejust 41 millimeters with the Azuro dial with the Roman numbers.
Yeah, this is a beautiful watch. Yeah. This is like a beautiful watch, can't lie.
I bought it for my birthday, 21.
Wow, yeah. That was like...
My first
watch. What is this watch meaning to you?
It's just my first watch. It's the watch I started everything with. Like all my watch addiction.
Yeah.
When I bought it, I didn't know.
You didn't know you were spending like millions in watches.
I didn't know what AP was. I knew nothing about watches when I bought this one. I just bought it because.
But when you look at this watch, what does it remind you?
It reminds me my first steps in like e-commerce, my first million, you know.
Yeah, crazy. Okay, so that's the first one. His first watch.
So I'm a huge AP lover. Okay, so you'll see a lot of AP. So that's an AP, another one. So it's the same that you just shown, yeah, but it's in rose gold.
Rose gold. And this one is a 50th anniversary?
Yeah, that's a 50th anniversary. It's the first Royal Oak I bought in boutique.
Wow.
Yeah, because now I like to, like, you know, I buy all my watches in boutiques. I
don't
buy
shop, yeah.
Yeah. I used to buy a lot of on the market, but I lost a lot of money. So now I stopped. I just buy in the boutique. Let me show you two watches that are not very famous, but it's APs. These two are called like Code 1159 by Audemars Piguet. So the first one here, it's in white gold, and the second one is in rose gold and black ceramic, and it has chronograph. So you see this watch and this watch, they have the same movement inside. It's the same.
Really?
Yeah, inside is the same.
Exactly. And how much is this watch in the shop, and how much is this one in the shop?
So this one in the shop is like 80,000 USD, yeah. I think. And this one is like...
30?
No, 50.
50?
Yeah.
And this one, it's more a watch that you buy when you really love AP. It's not a watch that people are gonna buy and do something with it, right?
Or maybe people who want something like a good watch, a good movement, like good technique, good manufacturer, but they don't want the Royal Oak like everyone.
That's like a proper watch lover. It's not like, oh, I love APs or whatever. Like when you own those watches, like you're like a serial AP lover.
And I'll show you two more that I just bought last month. So the first one is the Jumbo in 39 millimeters. So that's one of the most sought after watches in APs.
So how much did you buy this in the shop?
So this one, I bought it like 80K USD in the shop, and it's worth 180.
Oh,
yeah.
So if you would sell it, you're not obviously selling it.
No.
If you would potentially sell it, it's 100 bags.
Yeah, but you know this watch, when it was the peak of the watches hype in 2022, it was like 300K.
Wow.
Yeah, people were selling it and buying it like 350.
Massive.
And the last one is the same watch, but in stainless steel. So it's also one of the most sought after watch in the AP.
So they're exactly the same, guys. Yeah. I don't know if they're a Jumbo.
It's exactly the same watch.
Can you explain what Jumbo means?
Jumbo means like extra thin, because it's very thin, as you can see.
Yeah.
So
most APs are a bit like tighter, you know, white. And this one is like super thin, like it's crazy. And when you have this on your wrist, you almost don't feel it.
Yeah, you don't feel it. It's like a jewel. I like to wear it, but not every day.
It's crazy. I mean, when you look at all of this, so how much is this like worth in watches? 800K, a million?
Yeah, I'd say 1 million.
$1 million worth? I mean, if you take what's the rest in the sale, it's over a million, probably two.
Yeah.
These watches are just insane.
So yeah, it's a pretty sick collection. I also invest in art,
real
estate, so I love...
Oh, can you show? You have...
Yeah, I'll show you one stuff.
Oh, yeah. You can show us.
So this is a piece that I bought. It's very difficult to buy this straight from the galleries. Like the same thing as watches.
You got in the gallery?
Yeah, because I have a good plug there.
How much you bought?
So I bought it for 5,000 euro.
And how much at the all-time high it was going for?
Like 20, 25.
So imagine you buy something small like this, which is a paper A4, You buy five and go sell for 25. You made 20,000. It's what someone makes working in Tesco.
I have a lot of art. I have a lot of big paints and everything, but it's not here. It's in the storage.
It's crazy.
In the safe storage.
So that's what you do. Like, you collect watches, you invest in art, you do some trading. And what's your next goal?
To be honest, I don't know. I just want to have a big watch collection. I just want to have like more real estate in Dubai, because I think this city is like the future. Like, it's very attractive. Everyone is coming here and it's not going to stop.
And if someone is like young and thinking, like, I want to make money, I want to be able to have the same watches, buy art, and have like not an easy life, because obviously like you did so much hard work before, but now you're living like a retired life. It's true, you know, it's like most people do, like they put their money in a hedge fund, they wait. But you set up it in the hedge fund, you manage yourself, because obviously you're young. What would be the advice for someone who wanna achieve the same things as you in life?
So the best advice that I have is to open your mind. Like, you have to think about everything. You have to go out of your like little bubble, little space, you know, because you always talk to the same people, you meet the same people every time. So you have to move, you have to travel, you have to meet different people. Look a lot on YouTube or on internet, like which business can bring you money, which business you like. Of course, because if you don't like the business, you will never succeed.
Exactly. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode where I introduced to three of my different friends, Nathan, Jack, and Suleiman. They all have like a different background, but you can see at the end of the day, they had two things in common. The first one is obviously they're a millionaire, but the first one is that they all put a lot of effort and they all believe in themselves in order to achieve that financial freedom. So don't forget to hit the subscription button, like the video in case you like it, and if you want an episode 2, let me know in the comments, and I see you soon. Ooh.